Hi everyone, I'm Rain from the product team at Todoist. We've been working on workspaces for a while now. Since we opened up the beta in June last year, about 8,000 teams have joined us in testing workspaces, reporting bugs, helping us figure out what to build next, and generally getting workspaces ready for showtime. I'm excited to say that we're finally removing the beta label from workspaces and making it available to everyone. Once you get access, you will see a new section in your sidebar. Click on your team's name in order to access your team workspace. You can think of this place as a shared home for all of your team's projects. Browse through projects that other teammates have created, click on them to preview what's inside them, as well as join projects that you're not already a part of. Upon joining a project, it will also appear in your sidebar for easy access. Above your team projects, you will find your personal projects just as they were before. These projects belong to you, and nobody on your team can see them. Should you leave your team, these projects will still remain accessible to you. To get started, simply drag a team project that's currently within your personal project into your team workspace. Upon doing so, you will see the option to keep the access level as is, restricted, which means that only people that you've invited to this project can view it, or change it to full access, which means that any team member can easily view and join the project in order to collaborate with you. You also have the ability to create restricted projects when adding a new project in your team workspace. Just go into Add Project and then change the access level here. You can see that I currently have a restricted project within my workspace. This project is for my one-on-one with my manager, Dominic. Only Dominic and I can see this project. Nobody else in the Todoist workspace is able to access it. If you currently use subprojects, you'll notice a big change as well. In the team workspace, folders are used as a shared way to organize team projects. You can see in the Todoist workspace that we already have a couple of folders, and clicking to expand folders show you all the different projects that are within them. You can easily create a folder by going to the Add button, naming the folder, and selecting the projects you want to include within the folder. Another feature that we often use at Todoist nowadays is the ability to copy a project link and share it with someone else. Clicking on the link opens up the project immediately, which just allows quick access to the project. Links are also available for sections, tasks, as well as comments. When it comes to organizing your day and week, all of the tasks that are assigned to you, whether in your team or your personal projects, are available in the today and upcoming view. So for instance, here's my today view. There are many view options that are available for you to manage this information, including the ability to group your tasks by workspace. This gives you better separation and focus. For me personally, I prefer not to see my personal tasks when I'm at work. In order to achieve this, I use custom filters, which are available with workspaces as well. So you can see my favorites here that I have a custom view that I've created a custom view in order to only see tasks assigned to me and the Todoist workspace. Nothing in my personal projects appear here. Other than providing teams with more transparency and easier sharing, workspaces also give team admins the ability to control who has access to their projects. If you click on your team's name and then the members button at the very top, you'll see a list of people that currently have access to your team projects. You can invite more people to join your team by sending them the invite link or by inviting them via their email addresses. Admins also have the ability to change the role of individual members. You will notice that in this list, you will also see guests that only have access to specific projects within your workspace. The guest role is great for collaborating with external stakeholders on ad hoc projects. For instance, if you're working with a freelancer, or if you wanted to collaborate with your clients on a couple of projects. And I think that covers everything that I wanted to share with you in today's update. What I've just shown you so far is only the foundation of what's to come for team collaboration within Todoist. Check it out with your team and let us know what you think. Thanks very much for watching. Bye!